Oh yeah, hearing that beat, baby doll. We spinning those records live here on the Good News Network Radio Land. This morning, good Sunday morning, this is Wolfman Trav coming at you. Want to tell everybody over the radio waves, oh, good morning, good morning, good Sunday morning. Hope you're on your way to church. And while you are, we're going to bring you a little comfort today. Want to tell you, this is something new. We got a video camera in our studio today. Yes, we do. How y'all doing out there? Yeah, all y'all watching me live, seeing what's going on between these walls. This is it. This is the radio. This is where we make it happen, broadcasting live. Yeah, baby doll. Just, this is Wolfman Trav coming at you. Thank y'all for watching. Thank y'all for listening. Good news today. Oh, yeah. Is he with you? Is he your savior? Jesus. What are we going to talk about? Something new for us. Got my little computer here. Got some emails in for some listeners. And hopefully in the future I'll have some in from our viewers. That's right. While we're spinning these tracks. But I got an email here from someone you may know. Mr. Russ sent me an email, and our privileged anchor, our live and local breaking reporter, he says, and I quote, he says, let me get to it here, he says, Wolfman. I say, yeah. He says, Wolfman, who's one of your favorite characters in the Bible? Woo! Favorite character in the Bible. That's a hard one there, Mr. Russ. How are we going to answer that? There's so many, but that's okay, baby. Wolfman's going to answer that question for you. Well, we could start. We could start from the beginning, couldn't we? Yeah, old Wolfman likes Joshua. I like the Joshua. He's an important one, especially in the Old Testament. Well, we could start at the beginning, though. We could go Adam and Eve. Oh, yeah, important characters. We could go Moses. We could go Noah. Couldn't we? We could go Daniel or some of the prophets, other prophets. Couldn't we? Oh, yeah, we could. We could go into the New Testament. We could talk about any of the apostles, any of the disciples, couldn't we? We got 12 we could talk about, couldn't we? Oh yeah, we could. We could keep going and, of course, talk about the man himself. Jesus, oh yeah, we can. But he said characters. And, well, Mr. Russ, I'm going to tell you about one that we could go on and on about. Oh, yeah, baby dolls, and all you listening out there over the radio waves. This man, if you like movies, he was the original Indiana Jones. Oh, yeah. He was the original Indiana Jones before Indiana Jones, okay? They should have modeled the movies after his life, and kind of somewhat, I think, we could make that correlation. They should have called it Paul in Raiders of the Lost Ark. Paul and the Last Crusade, baby dolls, guys and gals. They could have called it Paul in the Temple of Doom. But they called it Indiana Jones, but oh no. Paul's life is much more exciting than any of those movies if you sit down and read it, little cats and dolls. That's right. Paul, who used to be called Saul, yeah, you hear me? You dig me? Was a wild man. He was a wild man. He was there when they were stoning Stephen, giving approval. He was there searching for letters to go house to house to get rid of the believers who were new converts to Christianity. They were so excited, and Paul thought this was wrong. It wasn't wrong. Oh, no. Later, we're going to read about that and how Paul was wrong. He was going house to house. He wanted to arrest them. He wanted to throw them in prison. He was going to take away the way. He wanted to stomp it out. Baby doll, but I'm telling you, over here watching and listening to us in radio land, he wasn't right. That wasn't right. After he was converted, he studied. The Lord took his life. That's right. Took his life, just like he took the wolf man's life and turned it around. He took Paul's life, he turned it around, and he went on missionary journeys. Missionary journeys. At least three. All over the known world at that time, preaching and telling people about Jesus and how he was turned away. If you're with me, get your Bibles out, okay? If you're with me, get your Bibles out. Let's talk about Acts. Turn to the book of Acts. It's right after John. About Acts. You hear those pages crumbling right here? We in the good book this morning. That's right. And for all you who are watching, turn to me. And all you who are listening, turn the radio dial up. Well, here we are. Stephen is being stoned. Stephen is the first martyr, the first recorded martyr that we know that died for his faith. He loved Jesus that much. And it says, while they were stoning him, I'm finishing chapter 7, going on to the first part of 8. He says, while they were stoning him, Stephen prayed, Lord Jesus, receive my spirit. Then he fell on his knees and cried out, Lord, do not hold this sin against them. When he had said this, he fell asleep. In other words, he died. The Lord took him right then and said, come on, Stephen. People are going to remember you. People are going to remember about Stephen. Here we are, over 2,000 years later, talking about Stephen. But all those people who were picking up those stones and throwing them at Stephen, they had to take off the coats, the cloaks, first. And guess whose feet they threw them at? Saul. Remember his name before? Paul, same guy, Saul, Paul. They were throwing them at his feet. They were taking off. They said, here, hold this while we take care of Stephen. That's right. And Saul was there giving approval to his death. In other words, he wasn't stopping them. He was trying to stomp out the way. He was sitting there watching them kill him. Old Wolfman ain't too happy about that one. Woo! No, sir, we can't have that. And it says, on that day, a great persecution broke out against the church at Jerusalem. And all except the apostles were scattered. They ran. They were scared. They could do that to us. They could kill us. But in doing that, when they scattered, so did the way. So did words about Jesus. So did life with Jesus. They spread out. And they went to other places. But they kept the faith. And they lived it out. And they told people about Jesus. That's right. So, they scattered. And throughout Judea and Samaria, godly men buried Stephen and mourned deeply for him. They were sad. Cats and dolls. They were sad. But Saul began to destroy the church, going from house to house. They knocked on a wolf man's door. Oh, no, 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 no. Saul, you better back up. Wolf man's coming for you. That wouldn't happen. But he went house to house. He dragged men and women and he put them in prison for loving Jesus. Now, ladies, this is the same man who wrote most of the New Testament. The same man who went for over 30 years telling people about Jesus. So what happened? How can he go from giving approval of killing a man to telling everybody about Jesus, who that first martyr, Stephen, was living for. Let's talk about it. Right here, it's on the Damascus Road. That little road, you know, it wasn't paved at that time. Pantagacus hadn't got there yet. Ooh, here we go. This is the conversion. Let's read about it. Turn up your radio dial if you're with me. Okay. Meanwhile, Saul was still breathing out murderous threats against the Lord's disciples. He went to the high priest and asked him for letters to the synagogues in Damascus, so that if he found any who belonged to the way, I'm in Acts chapter 9, by the way, flip your pages, whether men or women, he might take them as prisoners, put them in handcuffs, back to Jerusalem. He's going to arrest them. Wolfman ain't never been arrested. I ain't never had the cuffs of steel on my hands. Don't plan to either. So, as he neared Damascus on his journey, suddenly a light from heaven flashed around him and he fell on the ground. I'm talking about it was bright. It was brighter than this light around me now. It was bright. And he heard a voice saying, Saul, Saul, why do you persecute me? Now, if you follow along with me there on the TV, those words of my Bible went written in red. That means that's where Christ is talking. So, Jesus, in this loud voice, he can't see him, but it's that light. And he says, Saul, Saul, why do you persecute me? Why are you trying to arrest my followers? Why are you doing this to me? It just don't make no sense. He says, Saul says, who are you, Lord? Right then, he knew that he was dealing with somebody much more powerful than he could ever dream, ever. He says, why are you persecuting me? And that light, Jesus, who is the light, by the way, cats and dogs, the way, the truth, and the life. He says, I am Jesus who you are persecuting. Now get up, and go into the city. And you will be told what you must do. Now, Paul had some companions with him. He wasn't by himself. And the Bible goes on to say, it says, the men traveling with Saul stood there speechless. They heard the sound. They heard it, just like you hearing it on your radio waves. They heard the sound, but they didn't see anybody. Didn't see. Heard, but only saw, did not see. Saul got up from the ground, but when he opened his eyes, he couldn't see anything. Whoa, he was blind right there. Turned blind with that light. The blinded by the light. You've heard that song. We played it here before. Spinning it on them tracks on your FM dial. That's right. He couldn't see. So they led him by the hand. They carried him into Damascus and said, come on. And for 3 days he was blind. 3 days, ladies and gentlemen. This 30-something years old, all his life he could see and do just like you can. But now he's blind and being drugged by the hand by the man who were with him. And he didn't eat or drink anything. He was hungry. He was thirsty. But he didn't know how hungry and thirsty he was going to be in the future for the Lord, for Jesus. That's right. So, we got this other guy who was in Damascus where Paul was led to, where he was going to persecute the church, the believers. There was this other disciple there named Ananias, and the Lord called to him in a dream, in a vision. He said, Ananias. And Ananias said, yeah, Lord, I'm listening. He says, go to the house of Judas on Straight Street. Straight Street, that's right. Straight Street. and asked for the man from Tarsus named Saul. For he is praying. In the vision, he has been a man. There's seen a man named Ananias. That's you. Come and place his hands on him. Heal him so that he can see again. Ananias says, Lord. He says, Lord, I've heard about this guy. I know all about him and the bad things he wants to do. He says, he wants to arrest us. Are you sure? Basically, is all that what he says, kind of summarizing here. And the Lord says, go. This man is my chosen instrument. See what I'm saying, guys and dolls? Listen here, chosen instrument. You can be the chosen instrument for Christ too. In your home, in your school, in your work, playing everything, in your family. You can be God's chosen instrument by the way you think, the words that you say, just like the words coming over this microphone, over the airwaves now, and how you act and react to things. That's right. He's be the instrument, just like Ananias is. Or the Lord says to Ananias about Saul. He says, he's going to tell my name before the Gentiles. That's me and you. That's all you and Wolfman right here. We Gentiles. That's right. He says, and their kings and before the people of Israel. And I will show him how much he must suffer for my name. So Ananias said, okay, I'm going. Ananias went to the house and entered it, and placing his hands on Saul, he put his hands on old Saul right there, that blind Saul. He put his hands on him, and he says, Brother Saul, the Lord Jesus, who appeared to you on the road. See, the Lord told him what had happened. That same light, that was Jesus, who appeared to you on the road. He sent me to you so that you may see again. See, Ananias was a brave man. And he followed what the Lord had for him. He had courage. That's right, he had courage. Let's finish reading here. He sent me to you so that you may see again and be filled with the Holy Spirit. And immediately something like these old scales fell off his eyes. And he could see. Healed, that's right. He was healed. And he got up and was baptized, and after taking some food, he regained his strength. It's an amazing story of conversion. See, old Wolfman was converted too. Wolfman wasn't doing things right. Wolfman said, hey, I got to get things right with Jesus. I got to get on the straight and narrow, that straight street, if you know what I mean. That's right. So what do I mean with this story, this most important character? Thank Mr. Russell. Well, everybody in the Bible is important, right? Listening to me today and watching me today, everybody in the Bible is important, or they wouldn't be in the Bible. But we can learn a lot from all these people, and especially Saul, who I'm going to call Paul. We can learn all this from Paul. He was a wild man. He went on at least three missionary journeys. He was arrested. He was beaten. He was shipwrecked. They had to lower him out of the city wall from people who wanted to kill him. He was stoned left for dead. But God healed him because he wasn't done with him. And it's his missionary work to the Gentiles, me and you, that we have heard, or some of his efforts, we have heard about Christ and the good news and the way. That's right, old Wolfman knows about that. So he went on these missionary journeys telling people about Jesus and the way, and he discipled people, especially old Timothy. We can read about him, and he wrote these letters in the New Testament, these books of the Bible in the New Testament, letters of Paul, encouraging people how to live and what to do in Christ. We can learn a lot from old Paul. But here's the thing, he was converted. He turned from his old ways. Now, God got his attention a little different. Pretty dramatic. He turned and started following Christ. And that's what I want you to know today. Leave that old stuff behind. No matter the cost, it's worth it. You'll be great. Paul, he says he was the worst of the worst. Just old, dirty, nasty, mean. But God used him, and he can use you too. So there you go, newscaster Rust, number one anchor man on the Good News Network. I want to tell you thank you for your question on that computer there. They call it the email. And they got that, I think they got the internet on the computer now, something crazy. But anyway, we just want to tell you thank you. And two things before we get out of here and spin this other track. Wolfman will be back coming back to you. And until then, get out of my room. Let's spin it.